Hi everyone. So today we're going to do something a little different. I'm actually going to talk while I show you the process to show you a little bit of what I'm doing. Right now, I'm actually working on thumbnails, which what thumbnails are is they're little pictures that show you what's going on without having to draw out an entire image. Basically, these are stuff that are going to be really fast. They're going to be things that don't take a lot of effort. And then you're going to kind of elaborate on them a little bit depending on what you think might be more interesting. If you'll notice, when I do thumbnails, when I like a picture more than the rest of them, I'll work a little more on it. I'll give it a full body, I'll do all of the different muscles and everything, and then I'll decide. And what I did that with a couple of this one, but my favorite one does end up being this bottom one on the right. So what I do now is I end up giving her a little bit of the details to give me some ideas of what I like about her and seeing if this is really the one I want to do. I do eventually decide that it is, but she doesn't work very much in anything but a portrait. So I go ahead and I flip her over, I lower the opacity so that I can kind of see the outline, but I don't have so much color blocking my way. I then start to work on the sketch. Now, the sketch isn't going to be the most perfect thing ever. This is just us trying to block out all of the ideas, make sure that all of the details are on there, and really make the image come to life. After we finish the sketch, then we'll do line work. But right now, we don't need to worry about that. We just need to worry about getting the ideas and the details on the paper. Now, I mean, I don't want to say that I'm bad at drawing deer, but it is definitely not one of my strong suits. So I did look up a couple deer. It's on the other screen. I wish I could have popped it on this screen, but me and Sai have not figured each other out completely yet. Right now, my deer looks a little more like a donkey than a deer. But I did try to get some of the anatomy right. I did actually look up the way that angled faces work and everything else with deer, and this is about what I came up with. That's one thing that you always want to constantly be doing. If you're not good at something, look it up. Try and figure out what you can do to make it better. Had I just gone with my first instinct here, it would have looked awful. But it did at least come out a little bit better. It did look like a quadruped, if nothing else. All right, and now we're going to go ahead and move on to line work. Before I start to talk about this, though, I am going to point out, if you see on here, you've seen me saving a bunch of times. Do it all the time. Just save yourself the trouble and the tears of having to accidentally lose all of your work because, oh my God, the power just went out. It's happened to me so many times. I have lost hours of work. Please do yourself the favor and always save. Anyway, so lines. If any of you have seen any of my anime, you're looking at this and going, why are your lines purple? Most of your lines end up being a darker version of whatever color they are around. Well, what I do is I end up merging all of my lines to one layer at the end. And then I color all of the lines specifically while using the Preserve Opacity tool, which basically makes it so you can't color anywhere but where what's already been colored. And that'll actually show at the very end of this video, so don't worry too much about it now. I will explain it later. Also, I totally realized that I never gave her pants. That I didn't realize until I started working on line work, so I ended up kind of just pinning the pants on here in a few minutes. And it turned out okay, but that's only because I have drawn so many shorts in my days. So many shorts. It's not something I would recommend. I actually considered going through and doing the line or the sketching first, but I just kind of decided screw it and threw caution to the wind, and this is what happened. So, could they have come out better? Yes. Did they still come out good? I think so. So, it all depends on where you think you are at for the skill level, and just, do things the way you feel are right. Here's something I really do want to make a point of. If you are working on a piece and you find something that you are not satisfied with, go back and fix it. No matter how far you are in the piece, try your best to get it fixed because honestly, Otherwise, you're gonna look at it and you're just gonna be sad every time you see that one thing. I've done it. I've gotten lazy on a part and been like, I don't need to fix this. And then every time I look at that piece, that's all I can see is that mistake. So go back, you know, fix your legs, fix your eyes, fix the things that you think need fixed, and then just, you know, work on it from there. Also, totally psyching you out right now. I forgot that I have to do a thing before the color. This right here, this is called weighing your lines. I like to do a thick outline of each separate character, which is one way you can weigh lines. Another thing is if you notice the lines that are going downward also tend to be a little bit thicker. Oh yeah, I totally forgot to add her hand in, so I did that real quick. But yeah, so when you weigh your lines, you tend to mark in the shadows a little bit so that it rounds out and it's not super pointy edges. You also, lines that are, you know, more towards the floor are going to be a little bit heavier, things like that. It gives your character more of a sense of depth, more of a sense of existence, than just kind of leaving the lines how they are. And it also makes painting the color, like the colors in, so much easier. And we will touch on that in a second. But if you see right here how I'm adding in the shadows a little bit with my line work, that's not something that you have to do, but it is something that does help a lot when you're working on your character. Signatures aren't always something that you need to do, but I always feel that they're really good. And another thing that I do is whenever I post a picture and have the ability to tag, I always tag my signature name and my artist name just so that if someone wants to look me up specifically, it is there. That's something you should always try and think of doing too, because it does make it easier to look you up. All right, so now we're doing color. This one was really simple because all I had to do was pull colors from the actual character. One thing is whenever you're trying to color and the colors bleed over, you just grab the pen tool, you know, mark over the spot that's making it bleed and then paint in. It's fairly simple. All right, so we did the easy part of actually getting the colors in there. Now we're going to go ahead and start doing lighting and shading. And honestly, right now I am just playing with different colors. I'm actually trying to figure Sai out a little bit because, like I said, me and Sai haven't exactly figured each other out just yet. So, I started playing around with it and then I started in with the shading. And if you notice what I do is I tend to, for shading, move the color down a few steps and then also move toward blue, whichever way is fastest to get to blue. Not very much, just enough to add a definite color change as well as lighting change. So, it gives it a little bit more depth in my opinion and it pushes the more bright colors towards you, which is what I think is really important in shading. So, you know, I was messing around doing some different tests and then finally decided on, you know what, let's just do my normal shading. One time a really awesome artist told me, you know, it's always 2 o'clock in my own little world. And what he means by that is he always ends up doing the lighting from a very specific spot on the paper. I am also guilty of that, and my very specific spot is in the upper left-hand corner where the sun is more or less coming from the viewer's face and hitting the character. Yes, that is definitely a bad thing and something I need to work on specifically because I need to become more versatile, but it is also really cool to have that specific set of lighting because it does make it easier to know exactly where my light is going and what it's going to hit. But let's go ahead and talk about backlights for a little bit. If you saw on the sides over on the edge of the character, she's got all these bright lights now. Those bright lights are what we call backlights. They're things, or rim lights is another way to call them. And those basically show that there is light coming from another direction or there is light bouncing off something behind her and hitting her again. That's the thing, is light is very much, it bounces back and forth and everywhere. And so when you sit there and you look at something, you'll see that it has multiple colors when you look at it because it's getting hit by multiple different lights. And so that rim light is basically just to give her more of a realistic look. I mean, you know, as much as a deer girl can have a realistic look. And it makes her seem more real. It makes her seem like she's there, you know, if that makes sense. And it makes her pop. It really does give her a little bit more life. And so that's a big part of why you give them those lights. Again, with anime, it's okay to be a little bit generous to light or with light because it doesn't have to look 100% realistic. If you can make her pop while throwing like 50 different lights on her face, go ahead and do it. Have fun with color. That's what anime's for. And so basically, that's what I was doing here. And I was playing with a lot of different colors and lights and trying to really give her a bright look. So let's go ahead and talk about tools for a little bit because I know I haven't brought any of that up. And right now, I am using size, so there's a lot less tools to choose from unless you grab a bunch of different packs and things, which I haven't. I honestly have a very basic version of Sai. So right now, a lot of what I'm doing is I'm using the pen tool to fill in color, or sometimes the airbrush tool if I want it to look really soft. And then I'm using the water tool to blend. And that's really as simple as it gets, I know, but it's pretty, it makes it uncomplicated and it works really well. I mean, if it ain't broke, don't fix it, right? So, the very big thing that I have to point out is that when you're using the water tool for blending, there are four different settings on softness, and you want to use those. Right here is actually a good example. I started out with the really, really soft setting, and I ended up moving all the way up to like the third or the first or second hardest setting out of all of them, and then I you know, added the light first before blending everything and then just blended the whole thing together. And that is something you want to experiment with. Try and figure out what tool do you need here? What tool do you want to use? How do you want to make this look? And based on that, you want to kind of mess with the different tools. And yes, each different program is different. I don't recommend in Photoshop using the blur tool at all. I would honestly prefer you just go at it with opacity and flow than using the blur tool because the blur tool in Photoshop is not very good. But inside, blur tool away because it works great. So I'm nearing the end of the shading part now, and generally at this point is when I start to work on the eye. This is something I actually saw another artist do a while back that I just really loved, was actually taking the color of the eyes and adding a little bit of that color to the whites of the eyes to give the eye a little bit more depth. All right, remember how I brought up earlier the line work and how I actually changed the colors of the lines? Well, that's what I'm doing right now. And the first thing you want to do with that is you want to merge all of your lines to one layer. I generally go ahead and duplicate it so that I have that set of purple lines just to make sure that's not what I want to do. And then I set the new layer to preserve opacity on Sai. And that will make it so that you cannot color anywhere but on those lines, no matter how hard you try. If you notice, I'm going way out of the lines and it's not going to go anywhere but on the lines. Now, this I do tend to pick colors that are just a slight bit darker than whatever I'm working on. I don't always do that, and we'll see that when I work on the hair. I actually pick a much brighter color to make that hair pop a little bit more. So now I'm doing that with the hair. I am lighting it up. It does give it a lot more flair, which I really love, especially with this character. She is just so cute. Props to the creator. I will have the link to her artwork in my description. But other than that, I'm just going to keep working on these lines. I'm going to get this deer lined up with a bunch of really dark colors for brown, and then we'll go from there. All right, so now we're going to go ahead and move into some of the lighting tricks after I finish the nose. Most of these lighting tricks are just using a new layer in luminosity, unless, you know, I want to really work on it and make the whole thing super bright. But I've made a clipping mask so that nothing can be drawn except on the clipping mask layer, and just gave them a little bit more extra light. Now what I'm doing behind that is I'm giving them kind of a boxy background. I'm not giving them an environment because I didn't draw them with one in the first place. So nothing I add in there will make it work correctly. So instead I gave them a background, which a background's kind of just something to add a little bit of extra color behind them instead of making them on a blank white space. And I chose something with squares to give it more of a disco-y feel because, you know, it is called the Disco Deer and the Disco Fawn. I then moved into Photoshop so that I can play with some of the colors. I'm adding a little bit of lighting effects to the actual background to give it a little bit more pop, and to not make it so monotone. I also played with their lighting, but I didn't like any of it. So I finished the sketch or the signature, and this is what it ended up looking like at the end. Thank you guys so much for watching, and have a great day.